Good evening and welcome. We're so glad that you've joined us for our 14th annual fundraising event and Upsidedown auction. My name is Brian Peterson and I'm the executive director and co-founder of Reality Sports. Usually we'd be in a large pavilion right now at the Puyallup Fairgrounds enjoying a nice meal together. But even though we can't be together in person this year, these few minutes that we do have are going to be encouraging because God is at work. What we're going to see tonight are some highlights of the physical and spiritual training that's been happening this year despite all of the COVID challenges. We're also going to hear from an athlete and his family how God has been at work in their lives. And then we'll finish off the night with our signature Upsidedown auction. Before we do that though, I want to thank Josh Hall Real Estate and Rickabaugh Pentecost Development for being our title sponsors for this virtual event. A thank you to all of our event partners that you see at the bottom of the website event page as well. And I want to thank you, our donors, as the ministry that goes on day after day simply doesn't happen without your partnership. As you're watching tonight, you can pause it at any time and not miss out on anything. Simply hit the pause button if you need to stop for any reason and then push play again to pick up where you left off. See, that's even better than the real thing because if you need to go to the bathroom or hear something again, you can stop and rewind. Also, there will be a chat box that pops up on your screen to let us know that you're here and to communicate with others that are watching. We want to kick off our event tonight by showing you some of what's been going on in 2020. Since most of this year has been impacted by COVID restrictions, you're going to see that our coaches have had to be pretty creative to still train and teach God's word to athletes. Coaches have worked tirelessly with much smaller groups than normal, which means for most of the year, they've coached multiple sessions back to back in order to serve as many kids as possible. Take a look. It's so fun to see kids and adults in action. With all of the sports not happening over the last 8 months, you can know that the athletes you just saw have not taken for granted the opportunity to train. I mentioned at the beginning that usually we would be in person right now in an event center. It would be real in the sense that we would experience one another in the flesh. Bodies all in the same location. Right now, you're only seeing me on a screen. It's what we call virtual. And I was thinking about reality and all of the virtual opportunities we have now, and that we even have virtual reality. It can be very confusing as to what's really real, which leads me to the name, Reality Sports. The word reality comes from Colossians chapter 2, verse 17 in the New International Version, where the Apostle Paul writes this: "The reality, however, is found in Christ." In other translations, the word reality is substance. But perhaps the most helpful is the original Greek, which is the word soma, meaning body. In other words, Jesus Christ had a physical body. He was made of substance. He was real. This is such good news because it means that the God of the universe put on flesh and became a real person. He's not a distant, unknowable being. Jesus wasn't imagined. He wasn't a fairy tale. He wasn't virtual. The reality is Jesus Christ is not only fully man, he is fully God. And that's what reality sports is based upon. God the Father sending God the Son, Jesus Christ, with a real body to live without sin, unlike us, and to die a substitutionary death, the death we deserve for our sin, and then rising from death by walking out of the tomb in a real physical body. That means that upon faith in the person of Jesus Christ, we can have forgiveness of sin and real eternal relationship with the God who created us. Jesus gives us real purpose because he is the one who created reality. What does that have to do with sports? Everything. Being connected to the God who made us means that our wins and losses, our successes and failures, our sufferings and joys all have purpose and meaning. How can we find real meaning apart from the one who created reality? We simply can't. And so we have the joy and privilege of sharing the reality of Jesus Christ with athletes every day in 6 different sports programs: baseball, martial arts, strength and conditioning, tennis, wrestling, and volleyball. So I'm bummed that we're not together in body, substance, reality tonight. But by this virtual technology we have, God is still going to show us how real he is. We're now going to hear from one athlete and his family and how they encountered the reality of Christ. Meet Matthew and the messengers.
After junior year wrestling season, I was disappointed in my results and I was wanting to become a better wrestler. And so my mom and I, we started looking online for different programs during the off season so that I could just work on my wrestling skills. And that's when my mom found the Reality Sports website. And at the time, I wasn't really that deep in my faith yet. I hadn't really walked with Christ much yet. I had always gone to church with my parents, and my parents had always been extremely faithful, but I wasn't necessarily a believer yet. After practices and workouts, I would have questions that would be sparked in my mind from the messages that the coaches would give. And so I'd stay afterwards and I'd have conversations with them and just ask them questions, just, hey, you know, this message, I have this question about this, or, well, how does this work? And that's what really sparked my curiosity. It was at first just curiosity, but then it grew into something more. It grew into faith. And so that's when I really started to walk with Christ and I started to read my Bible. It was actually the Bible I got from Reality Sports that I started to read more. I started to pray, to just try and get as much of an understanding of the gospel as I could. Something I was struggling with is I had tied my identity as a person, is as I am a wrestler, that is who I am. And so what began to happen is there was a transition from my identity being tied with me being a wrestler and my identity tied with me being a son of God, a child of God and a Christian. So during Immerse, I was really looking to try and grow and just continue to walk with Christ. During the 7th week of the internship, we went on a 5-day backpacking trip. One of the days that, I think it was the 4th day that we were on the trip, we decided to hike up to the top of the mountain peak. just spent that time alone with God in His creation. And during that time, I felt what I know now as the Holy Spirit. And I wasn't really sure before that what that really meant, because I hadn't really felt that. But it was just through that prayer and just that intentional time alone with God that I was able to feel that connection and feel connected to God through His creation. And that was, I would say, one of the most life-changing experiences I've had.
Enter Matthew asking these questions outside of church, wanting to know more. And it baffled me because I had no answers. I had
challenging questions, things he would come to us and we would just be like, where are you hearing this? And, oh, I heard it, you know, Coach Peterson was talking about this at practice. And I'm like, during wrestling? Like, and so we just really, he started to lead our family in that direction of asking these really tough questions of, why do we attend the church that we attend? Why do we believe the way that we believe? Why do we pray before dinner? He's suggesting things to his siblings to help mom and dad around the house. He's talking about what it looks like to bless other people. Not language he learned from us, but language he picked up through training. And so we began to kind of take his lead. And we started asking of each other, what are we doing? How are we blessing each other? How are we blessing our family? How are we leading in these things? And we came to a point where we realized priorities weren't straight and things needed to change. And that's about the time that Immerse starts. And he decided he wanted to apply for it. And so he goes through Immerse, and immediately he is transforming before us into this young man that is walking for the Lord. It's no longer about just blessing other people or learning more. It is now he's wanting to give it away. And he wants to share what God's done in his life, and he wants to impact other people. And so we see Matthew go off to church. And little by little, we just start asking questions of, well, what are you learning at church and what's going on with you? And these conversations that we're having back and forth. And he said, well, why don't you come with me? And so he takes his family to church. You know, he's invites his parents and his four siblings to go to church with him. And he takes us to a service. And I got it. I'm like, ah, this is what he means. This is the fellowship in the community that we've been missing.
I think initially, the more I learned about God and Jesus, the more I began, I think, beating myself up and doubting myself, which caused more of a downward spiral, I think. But at some point along this process, I realized that it's not through me and what I'm doing, it's through God's grace. I feel like with the twins, we almost had a chance to start over, in a sense, and do the things that we didn't set out initially to do. Teaching that Jesus isn't just somebody you read about, and it's not just something that you learn about in church. It's something that we should serve, that loves us regardless of whether we love him back even, or whether we deserve it. And that's, we've just tried to really instill that in them. We hadn't really taught that. We hadn't pursued it ourselves. So to try and teach that to our children really was a foreign thing to us. Mm-hmm. But now it's just part of our life. It's part of who we are. It's part of what we teach them. And to see them not only listen to us, but to want to pursue that themselves has been a huge blessing for us. Things that we always did, but did out of obligation before, and now we're doing out of love. Because we want to grow that relationship with Christ and be closer with one another through that.
So I remember the first time that Matthew and I met at a coffee shop to talk about his interest in the Immerse summer internship. And as I heard Matthew's story, and I'd coached him in wrestling for quite a while, I thought that Matthew was probably not quite ready for what we envisioned the internship to be. And I sat with Matthew and really wondered where he was. But as we prayed about who these interns were gonna be, I had this overwhelming sense that Matthew was a guy that we were to invest in that summer. That whether he ever coached with us or not, I sensed God had a plan for him that summer, that it would be more about Matthew than it might be about what Matthew could do for Reality Sports. And so we accepted him into the program, and I'm so glad we did. Over the course of those 8 weeks, Matthew went from a guy who I wasn't sure even where he was in his faith journey, to a guy who was proclaiming the gospel in sports camps, who was ready to give his faith away, who was even talking about the opportunity that he would have at Seattle Pacific University in the fall to start leading others to experience Jesus and to walk with them and answer their questions and just help them know the God who created them.
Not only had we had that community among the interns where we were praying together, we were doing Bible study together, and we were just worshiping God together, but we also were going to Summit Christian Fellowship Church together. After going to college, I wanted that to stay a part of my life. And so that's when I brought all these things that had been collecting up until that point, and I brought it into my life at Seattle Pacific University. There's small groups on campus in the dorms that are ran by student ministry coordinators, and they're students on campus that are looking to lead ministries, and they plan things like chapel and like small groups and Bible studies and things like that. I saw it as a great opportunity to continue to just grow and learn like I had been in the internship, and just try and reach others who maybe might need someone to even just pray with and someone to walk with them in their faith journey. And the goal is always to, you know, make disciples, but if that doesn't happen, that's completely okay. My goal with that was just to be someone that someone can go to and just walk with in their faith if they don't know where else to go, and someone they know that this is someone I can pray with, and someone who can battle with some of these maybe questions and doubts that they might have. So last year I had to come home due to COVID, and so that opened up an opportunity for me to have a coaching position at Reality during the summer. And I was able to coach a strength and conditioning class. And through that class, that was a great way for me to develop, in the sense that I was able to use what I had learned and to apply that to conversations. It gave me a chance to continue to just walk not only with Christ, but walk with others in that, and maybe battle with some questions that maybe arise together.
Got to see Matthew continue to grow in his ability to communicate the word, to even incorporate his own experiences into sharing what it was to be a disciple. And so through that coaching experience, he just got more opportunity to develop as a disciple maker, that now, as he's on campus at Seattle Pacific University, walking in this student ministry coordinator position, he's got this toolbox to draw from. This toolbox to make disciples, to replicate other followers of Jesus, and and cast the vision for them to continue to make disciples. And so it's been so cool to watch Matthew on this journey, going from someone who had faith in their family but had not really made it their own, to discovering who Jesus was personally, to coming to this realization that Jesus was the king of his life, that he was calling him to live on mission, and now watching him walk out that mission on his college campus, back here at Reality Sports, with his siblings and his family plugged into church community. Matthew is a story of what the gospel does. It redeems broken sinners, it restores them to their God-given purpose, and it propels them into a life of purpose and multiplication for the kingdom of God.
I never get tired of hearing stories like Matthew's. Matthew is just one of the nearly 1,000 athletes our coaches have trained physically and spiritually in 2020. His story is not unique. There are literally hundreds of athletes and families in our programs that are in process like Matthew has been over the last few years. Reality Sports is really a team of missionaries who have committed their lives to serving athletes and families in the South Puget Sound region by teaching them the reality of physical and spiritual growth in relationship with Jesus Christ. Our vision is to see the world turned upside down through sport, meaning that athletes like Matthew, as they follow Jesus, will themselves go make disciples of Jesus wherever he takes them, whether here at Reality Sports or somewhere else. The platform of sport simply provides a fantastic opportunity to make disciples who will in turn make disciples impacting the world. Since 2006, more than 14,000 athletes like Matthew have been encouraged and taught how to walk as disciples of Jesus in every area of their lives. We believe God calls all of us to participate in this great mission with Jesus to make disciples. And you can join in that mission in a number of ways: by praying with us, by volunteering as a coach with us, and by becoming a monthly partner with us. Click the button on your page that says pray if you would like to join our prayer team. We have over 100 people on our team that receive monthly prayer guides so that they can be praying for athletes like Matthew and our missionaries that serve him. If you sense God calling you to be on the ground training athletes, click the button on your page that says volunteer to join our team. Every day, there are young people in our culture that do not know the reality of Jesus Christ. They simply don't know what their purpose is. We need more coaches in more sports in more cities who will have the courage to use their gift of coaching to reach young people through sport. So you can pray, you can volunteer, and you can become a monthly partner. We have faithful directors that are missionaries in their sport who know the language and the customs of that particular sports culture in order to reach athletes with the gospel. They lead a team of coaches who love and serve kids every day like Matthew. The livelihood of these directors and their ongoing ministry with athletes depends on monthly support. If you click the button that says give on your page, it will take you to a page where you can designate a monthly recurring gift to a specific program and missionary. Simply follow the prompts on the donation page to select the program, the amount, and then you can make it a recurring donation by selecting that choice. Monthly donations are critical for these missionaries to budget each year so that they can be as effective as possible in making disciples of Jesus in their sport. If you would like to give a one-time gift, you can designate that as well. If you're not wanting to donate online, you can certainly send in a check instead to the P.O. box on the donation page. There's also a response card in the form of a PDF that you will download to send in along with your donation so we know how to apply your gift. I want to thank you for supporting the work of our missionaries who are on the ground ministering to families like the Messengers. Also, make sure to click the Stay Connected button if you're not already receiving regular communication from us. We want you to hear about what God is doing throughout the year. We send out regular updates, and we want you to be encouraged by those stories. Now, we want to close out our evening like we do every year with the fast-paced upside-down auction. I want to turn it over to our ever-famous MC of the auction, Damon DeLapp, who is also our director of tennis.
Hey, thanks for being here tonight, but you know what time it is. It is time for our Reality Sports Upside Down Auction. It's different than a normal auction would be in that you bid on an item and you get to take it home with you. Here, you are simply gonna bid on an item that Reality Sports needs and their programs so they can continue to train kids both physically and spiritually. It's backwards, it's upside down. But here's how it's gonna go. We're gonna hear from each program director about their immediate needs that they have for training. A picture will appear on the screen in a pop-up that you can see exactly what they're talking about. At the end, after we've heard from all the directors, you'll click on the button on your screen that says Purchase Auction Items. That will take you to a page where you can put the items in a cart and then check out to pay for those items. We want to encourage you to wait. Be patient. Wait till the very end of the auction and click on the Purchase Auction Items button. We want you to see each program director and what their needs are. If you click it too early, you won't be able to see them, but you'll be able to hear what they're talking about. So don't click too early. Here we go. Are you ready, Pam? Kick it off for us.
Thanks, Damon. Hi, my name is Pam King, and I am the director of volleyball at Reality Sports. We're here at Lighthouse Christian Center in Puyallup, where some of the Reality Sports training occurs. I want to give a big thank you to Lighthouse Christian Center for their generosity in allowing us to use this court space, especially in a time when finding court space is so difficult. So thank you to Lighthouse Christian Center. What do we need for volleyball this year? We need 2 scoreboards for scrimmages and for tournaments. We also need 3 travel size electric ball pumps. We also need 4 plyometric boxes so we can continue with our fitness training. And the last thing that we need is we need a new set of antennae for the net. So I just want to thank you for partnering with us so we can continue to serve the girls of Reality Sports Volleyball. Over to you, Rusty.
Thanks, Pam. Hi, I'm Rusty Tyak. I'm the Director of Martial Arts here at Reality Sports. We're standing in the training facility in Puyallup, Washington. This year, we need a number of items to bless the families who come through the door of Reality Sports Martial Arts. First of all, we're looking for a pair of climbing ropes that we can attach to the ceiling. This will allow the students to get a little better warm-up before each class. Secondly, we're looking for a gallon jug of mat disinfectant that we can use to clean the mats after every session. Third, we're looking for a logo, just like the one that's on my shirt here, that we'll be able to cover almost the entire wall with on the backside of our gym, that will allow also for the students, children through adult, to sign just to create a little bit more unity and people can see just how many people are being blessed through the gospel of Jesus Christ here at Reality Sports. And then finally, we're looking for scripture, some die-cut vinyl scripture decals that we can place on the beams that are holding up the heavy bags that you can see behind us. And that would just be a great marker for newcomers that come in the door, as well as the students who are regular attenders, just to remind us who's blessing the students here, and that's our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So thank you for partnering with us and blessing the students and the families in this community as they come through the doors of RSMA. Over to you, Matt.
Thanks, Rusty. My name is Matt Voss, and I'm the director of wrestling here at the Reality Sports Wrestling Club. And tonight, I'm in our wrestling room at the Puyallup location. Now, we have a number of supplies that we need in order to continue training wrestlers here. We need 2 gallons of mat cleaner so that our mats can stay disinfected and keeping our athletes safe and healthy. We also need, though, 2 buckets of defense body wipes so that when our kids are done working out, they can wipe their skin down before they jump in the shower when they get home. We also need 12 rolls of mat tape so that our mats can continue to be held together. Thank you for partnering with Reality Sports Wrestling. Over to you, Tim.
Thanks, Matt. Hi, my name is Tim Kuykendall, and I'm the director of baseball here at Reality Sports. We're on the turf here indoors where we train during the rainy winters in Tacoma. We need a number of items to serve baseball players this year. We need 6 dozen a game baseballs for when we start playing tournaments again. We also need 3 buckets of practice baseballs to make our practices go great. We also need 3 fungo bats. They're long, skinny bats that coaches hit fly balls and infield ground balls to. That's all we need. We thank you guys for joining Reality Sports and making baseball happen in the Puget Sound. Over to you, Josh.
Thanks, Tim. My name's Josh Breffel, and I'm the Director of Coaching Development for all of the programs at Reality Sports, but I have the opportunity to coach different classes under our strength and conditioning program, and I'm here in Puyallup, Washington at our Reality Sports Training Center weight room. And I'm going to share with you a few items that we could use to continue to reach kids through strength and conditioning. The first thing is we actually need more of these medicine balls. We need different sizes, and 8 more of these would be a huge blessing. Next, we could use more kettlebells. We need different sizes of those as well. And then lastly, we need some gym chalk for when our hands get sweaty and a bucket to be able to keep that clean in our gym. So those are the needs that we have in strength and conditioning. Thank you for considering supporting this program and allowing more kids to be reached with the gospel through strength and conditioning. Over to you, Damon.
Hey, thanks, Josh. Damon Lapp here again, but this time as the director of tennis. I'm out here on the courts, as you can see, getting ready for summer tennis camps. This last year, Reality Sports had to make a tough decision. Due to the COVID scare, we had to cancel our summer tennis program. What that means for us in Reality Sports and for you as well is the items that were purchased last year in the Upside Down auction, the tennis balls, the cones, the jump ropes, they're waiting to be used for this next summer. So I want to thank you in advance for buying those items. There are some items, however, that all of our programs need and use in order to run the ministry. First of all, are some basic medical kits that we are trying to build and restock for this next year. We need athletic tape. That's $55 a box, and we need 6 boxes. We need pre-wrap to go underneath that tape, and that's $60 a box, and we need 6 boxes of those. We need ice packs. We don't wanna have to use them, but we need to be prepared. That's 6 cases of those that we need. And we need Band-Aids, $20 a box, and we need 6 boxes of Band-Aids. Finally, we come to the most crucial piece of equipment needed for our ministry. As athletes like Matthew, you heard earlier, we want every athlete that comes through the door of Reality Sports to walk away with a Bible in their hands so they can read it at home for themselves. Will you partner with us so that we can put God's word into the hands of athletes when they come through our doors? We have 10 cases of Bibles needed, and they are $100 a case. Would you partner with us on that? Thank you so much for your support. Now, back to you, Damon, for some final instructions. Hey, thanks, program directors, and thank you for being here this evening and prayerfully considering purchasing items for our programs. After Brian Peterson closes out our evening is when you will purchase your auction items by hitting that button at the bottom of your screen. There's a couple things I need you to pay attention to, though, and I want you to know. When you're ready to check out and pay for those items, it will be a separate transaction than as if you donated earlier with a one-time gift or be if you became a monthly partner. So we'll ask you for your billing information again, because the items that you purchase will be put into a cart, and that will be a separate transaction. But I want to thank you for partnering with us to serve athletes with the reality of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Damon, and thank you for joining us tonight. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. In fact, there's a number on your screen right now that if you text a message to the number, you will get a call back to answer your questions. Tonight, we've seen highlights of athletes training and hearing God's word despite tough circumstances. We've heard about how an athlete and his family are experiencing the reality of Christ. And you have supplied some real immediate needs for training through our Upside Down auction. For those who are joining us in prayer, by volunteering, or by becoming a monthly partner or giving a one-time gift, thank you. If you're hearing about Reality Sports for the first time and are just gathering some information, thank you for being with us. It is an honor to be on mission with you, helping athletes see the reality of Jesus and making disciples of Christ who are going out and turning the world upside down.